Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. And in this particular video we are going to talk about nodule formation. So in the very last lecture we have talked about some symbiotic bacteria that are responsible for the fixation of nitrogen. So wahan par humne baat ki thi about rhizobium, okay, which is responsible for the fixation of nitrogen in leguminous plant by the formation of nodules. And the second one is Frankia, which is responsible for the nitrogen fixation in plants like ulnus, which are non-leguminous, with the help of nodules as well. So hum yahan par padhne wale hain a basic mechanism that how nodules are formed. Okay, so we are taking the example of most common bacteria, that is rhizobium, in soybean. Okay, a plant that is soybean, that how nodules are constructed. So this is going to be a very basic mechanism which is given in NCERT and is quite important from examination point of view. So you have to pay a little bit attention. Okay, so sabse pehle kya hoga, there is a root. We know very well about the structure of plant. If we will talk, this is plant root and this is root here. So these are going to be the cells. Okay, these are basic cells of cortex, endodermis and different kind of cells, and this is root here. Okay, so there are different kind of rhizobiums. Let's say there are 4 rhizobiums. So ab ye kya karenge, the very first step is the division of rhizobiums. The rhizobium will start dividing and their number will increase enormously. Okay, so this is the very basic mechanism. Hum padh kis bare mein rahe hain, root ki association. So obviously we have to construct a root. Second thing is rhizobium, that is the bacteria. So we have to make bacteria. After that the bacteria will start dividing. So the very first thing is ki they will start dividing. Now the second thing is infection and kerning. They will form an infection thread. So sabse pehle the root will get a signal, okay, that the amount of rhizobium is quite high. So high number of rhizobiums surrounding a particular root here will make the root here to form a curl. Okay, a curly structure. This is a curly structure known as root curl. Okay, root curl. So ab curl ban chuka hai due to the high amount of rhizobium around root here. So now this is root curl. Now the rhizobium will infect it. What is the meaning of infection? It simply means that the rhizobium will enter the root here. Okay, so sabse pehle kya hua, rhizobium aaya, it has divided. The high number of rhizobium has led the root to become a little bit curly. Okay, curly banne ke baad kya hua, the rhizobium has entered into the curly root part. This is known as infection thread because the root here is quite thin, like thread. Okay, and the rhizobium is infecting it. That's why it is known as infection thread. So this is now an infection thread and all the other cells are present inside the thread because this is the extension of epidermis. Root here jo hota hai, epidermis ka outgrowth hota hai. Lekin iske andar epidermis ke alawa there are many layers. Hum anatomy mein padh chuke hain, there is hypodermis, there is cortex, there is endodermis, there is pericycle, there is pith. There are many things in present in the stem and root of plants. Okay, there are some exceptions as well, but hame yahan par uski baat nahi karni. So there are many cells inside it. This is the extension of epidermis. So yahan par kya hua, curl ho chuki hai root and the rhizobiums have infected the cells or infected the root hair cells, which is known as infection thread. Okay, so via infection thread, via this thread, the rhizobiums will enter into the cortex. Okay, so let's say this red one is the rhizobium. So this red one has entered into the cortex cells now. So after entering into the cortex cell, they will differentiate to form rod shaped bacterioids. Okay, rod shaped bacteroids bana lega ye bacteria. तो सबसे पहले क्या था, अपनी नॉर्मल शेप में था. आफ्टर इन्फेक्टिंग इट हैज पास्ड टू द कॉर्टेक्स सेल. ओके, कॉर्टेक्स सेल और वहां पर उसने क्या किया, इन्फेक्शन करके वो पहुंच गया। आफ्टर दैट वहां पर जाके इसकी थोड़ी बहुत डिफरेंशिएशन हो जाती है, इट हैज मॉडिफाइड इटसेल्फ इनटू द रॉड शेप बैक्टेरॉइड्स। ओके, सो नाउ इन द कॉर्टेक्स द रूट फॉर्मेशन इज और नोड्यूल फॉर्मेशन इज इनिशिएटेड। दिस इज क्वाइट इंपॉर्टेंट दैट ऑन व्हाट पार्ट ऑफ रूट द नोड्यूल फॉर्मेशन इज इनिशिएटेड। आफ्टर द इंसर्शन ऑफ राइजोबियम इनटू द कॉर्टेक्स सेल, उसके बाद ही नोड्यूल फॉर्मेशन इनिशिएट हो पाती है, उससे पहले नहीं हो पाती। सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट फ्रॉम एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ दैट द नोड्यूल फॉर्मेशन इज स्टार्टेड और इनिशिएटेड इन कॉर्टेक्स रीजन। दिस इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट। सो आफ्टर द राइजोबियम इज नाउ प्रेजेंट इन कॉर्टेक्स रीजन, सो द सेल्स ऑफ कॉर्टेक्स एंड पेरिसाइकल विल डिवाइड। ओके, तो यहां पर जो कॉर्टेक्स एंड पेरिसाइकल रीजन के सेल्स थे, दे हैव स्टार्टेड डिवाइडिंग बाय द वर्च्यू ऑफ एंट्री ऑफ राइजोबियम। ओके, राइजोबियम की एंट्री की वजह से जो पेरिसाइकल एंड कॉर्टेक्स के सेल्स थे, दे हैव स्टार्टेड डिवाइडिंग, दे हैव डिवाइडेड अलॉट, सो दे हैव फॉर्म मेनी सेल्स। ओके, एंड दे विल फॉर्म अ राउंड स्ट्रक्चर दैट इज नोन एज नोड्यूल, दैट इज नोन एज नोड्यूल। And we are learning about nodule formation. So this is the most important step. सबसे पहले क्या होगा? Rhizobium आया, it has divided. Due to the division of rhizobium, the root will curl. After that, the rhizobium will enter via making an infection phase. Infection होने के बाद, infection thread से होते हुए, it will go to the cortex. And in cortex, the nodule formation will be initiated. And the cortex and pericycle cell will start dividing. They will form a mass of cells, and that mass of cell, round mass of cell, is known as nodule. This is the ultimate aim. हम क्या करना चाह रहे हैं? We are going to talk about nodule. So this is the basic mechanism of nodule formation. And this rod-shaped bacteroids is also quite important. So after entering cortex, the nodule formation is initiated, and the division and differentiation will take place, after which the nodule is formed. Okay, this is the very basic mechanism. Now there are different kind of supplies, different kind of vascular supplies. We know very well about xylem and phloem. So after the division, now the rhizobium is in contact with the vascular supply. Iske paas nodule ke paas kya hoti hai? Vascular supply bhi hoti hai, so that it can exchange nutrients. So, कोई भी दिक्कत नहीं होती इसे न्यूट्रिएंट्स को लेने में, बिकॉज दे डू हैव अ वास्कुलर सप्लाई, दे हैव कनेक्टेड विद द वास्कुलर सप्लाई ऑफ होल प्लांट, सो द नोड्यूल इज वेल वास्कुलराइज्ड। इसके पास वास्कुलर सप्लाई होती है। ओके, सो इसकी जो मेन एम है वो क्या है? कॉर्टेक्स में जाने के बाद द कॉर्टेक्स एंड पेरिसाइकल विल डिवाइड, आफ्टर डिवाइडिंग दे विल फॉर्म अ मास ऑफ सेल दैट इज नोन एज द नोड्यूल, बट एज वेल एज they will also form a kind of vascular connection with the other plant parts, so that they may exchange nutrients easily. Aur is nodule mein sari important cheeze hoti hain which are responsible for nitrogen fixation, that is nitrogenase. In the last lecture we have talked about nitrogenase enzyme, which is responsible for the conversion of N2 into ammonia. Okay, and ammonia is the first stable product of nitrogen fixation. Because what is the definition of biological nitrogen fixation, जो हमने last lecture में पढ़ी थी, that is the conversion of nitrogen into ammonia is biological nitrogen fixation. So ammonia is the first stable product of biological nitrogen fixation. After that we can convert the ammonia into nitrite and then into nitrate with the help of different bacteria. लेकिन ammonia is the first stable product. So this is quite important from examination point of view as well. काफी ज्यादा बार पूछा जा चुका है। सो द नाइट्रोजिनेज है, और देयर इज अनदर थिंग दैट इज लैग हेमोग्लोबिन। वी हैव आल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट द लैग हेमोग्लोबिन इन लास्ट लेक्चर। लैग हेमोग्लोबिन विच इज अ मोलिब्डेनम एंड फेरस कंटेनिंग सब्सटेंस। मोलिब्डेनम भी होता है इसमें एंड आयरन भी होता है। सो व्हेन वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द इंपॉर्टेंट facts about different minerals and different elements, then we have talked about nitrogen fixation, that molybdenum is important for nitrogen fixation as well as iron. So they are utilized in this process, that is nodule formation. So यहाँ पर इनकी जरूरत पड़ती है in nitrogen fixation. So leg hemoglobin, which is pink or reddish in color, we have talked about it in the previous lecture, contains molybdenum and iron. And there is nitrogenase, which will convert nitrogen into ammonia. So the nitrogenase is quite sensitive. Okay, काफी sensitive होता है. कैसे? Because it cannot perform nitrogen fixation in the presence of oxygen. If there is oxygen, it cannot fix nitrogen. So, जो nitrogenase है, it will take care कि oxygen ना हो. It will try that the atmosphere will be a little bit anaerobic. Not the whole atmosphere. Actually, the atmosphere in which the rhizobium is working must be anaerobic so that it can fix nitrogen. Okay, in the deficiency of oxygen or in the anaerobic atmosphere. So, अगर oxygen present होगा तो rhizobium नहीं कर पाएगा nitrogen fixation. So, there must be anaerobic environment जो कि maintain करेगा nitrogenase enzyme. और ये दोनों मिलके कोशिश करते हैं like hemoglobin and nitrogenase कि कम से कम oxygen present हो, जिससे कि जो nitrogen fixation है that must be more efficient. Okay. So there is also a basic equation. Let's talk about it. There is N2, okay, plus 8H positive, that is proton, plus 8 electrons, plus 16 ATP. This is the very basic reaction, okay. There is nitrogen, plus there is 8 electrons, 8 protons, and 16 ATP, which will form ammonia. So there is 2 nitrogen, so obviously there are 2 ammonia, 2 NH3. ओके, टू नाइट्रोजन आर बैलेंस्ड. यहां पर भी दो नाइट्रोजन है, वहां पर भी दो नाइट्रोजन एटम हो गए इन टू अमोनिया. ओके, सो टू अमोनिया यहां पर बन चुका है, 2NH3 एंड इन 2NH3 टू इंटू 3 हाइड्रोजन आ चुके हैं. सो देयर विल बी 2 प्रोटॉन्स लेफ्ट. ओके, एंड 16 ATP विल फॉर्म 16 ADP प्लस 16 इनऑर्गेनिक फॉस्फेट. दिस इज अ वेरी बेसिक रिएक्शन. ओके, सो इसे आसानी से हम याद कर सकते हैं कि नाइट्रोजन प्लस 8 प्रोटॉन प्लस 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन प्लस 16 ATP. तो 16 ATP से क्या बनेगा? ऑब्वियसली 16 ADP प्लस 16 PI, दैट इज इनऑर्गेनिक फॉस्फेट, 2 प्रोटॉन्स लेफ्ट एंड 2 अमोनिया मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो नाइट्रोजन इज गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू अमोनिया. सो दिस इज द वेरी बेसिक रिएक्शन ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल नाइट्रोजन फिक्सेशन एंड दिस इज द बेसिक प्रोसेस ऑफ नोड्यूल फॉर्मेशन. सबसे पहले राइजोबियम आएगा, इट विल डिवाइड. राइजोबियम के डिवाइड होने से क्या होगा? रूट विल कर्ल. आफ्टर द कर्लिंग ऑफ रूट द राइजोबियम विल इन्फेक्ट द रूट एंड इट विल पास थ्रू द इन्फेक्शन थ्रेड एंड इट विल रीच कॉर्टेक्स. आफ्टर रीचिंग द कॉर्टेक्स रीजन इट विल गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू रॉड शेप्ड बैक्टेरॉइड्स एंड द कॉर्टेक्स एंड द पेरिसाइकल सेल्स विल डिवाइड अलॉट. आफ्टर दैट दे विल फॉर्म अ मास ऑफ सेल दैट इज यूजुअली नोन एज द नोड्यूल. और वहां पर क्या होगा? There is vascular supply as well as nitrogenase and leg hemoglobin present, which is quite important for the fixation of nitrogen into ammonia. So I hope कि आपको nodule formation का mechanism समझ में आया होगा. अगर आपको ये video lecture पसंद आया और समझ में आया, then please do hit like button. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, तो अपने दोस्तों को मेरे channel के बारे में जरूर बताइए और मेरी video को उनके साथ share कीजिए. Thank you so much. Keep supporting, keep loving my efforts and stay tuned.